Today we're going to look at the Fred from Raytech. Okay then, before we get to this, which we think solves a problem, you've got something off your chest.
Yeah, well, a few things that irritate me.
I knew that was coming. Along with this, Gordon.
Yeah. Okay, on surface wiring, you know, you've got a nice property and someone's cluttered it with conduit and junction boxes and things like that. Now, obviously, there's certain instances where you can't avoid that, but I like to minimise that if at all possible.
So we think that this can maybe tidy up those installations along with our cable selection. And what cable did we select, Gordon?
Yeah, so we've got NYY cable, which again we think is quite an underused cable in this country.
Yeah,
I like to sort of, it's armoured cable without the armour. So check out our video on that. But you know, pretty similar to using, I would say, a PVC conduit as we saw on that earlier installation.
Let's see the one that I've produced behind us then. So this is what we've got. We're coming out of the Fox box, which we've done in a previous video. I've come down, done a short runner cable, obviously, for the point. Then we've got the Fred, and from the Fred, we've got the ability to flex into a light fitting, and that's a really neat installation, we believe, don't we, Gordon?
Yeah, it is, especially we coupled it with some linear fire clips.
Yeah, okay.
Which we've got here, which again, when you fix that with this narrow diameter cable,
yeah.
So we're just under 10 millimeters across for that.
Gives an almost invisible fixing, doesn't it?
Yeah, almost invisible fixing, and I think that creates a lot tidier installation.
Okay, so let's come back to Fred, as we've left him now. So Fred here, we're gonna have a closer look, and I know exactly what you're gonna do straight away. So let's have a look at this waterproof enclosure. Easy, here we come. So in we come, what are you gonna do first for me, Gordon?
Stick my fingers straight into the ectoplasm.
Okay, for
so
those.
So we've got the gel. And again, the gel stops the ingress of water through cables, which we did speak about in our review of the Fox box.
Okay, yeah, we did on the Fox box.
Yeah.
So what we've got here then is we've got this waterproof gel in order that we can make our connection for our NYY and our flex in there. It comes with some bits in the box, so they're here.
So you have a normal connector.
Yes.
Which, yeah, people immediately are going to be saying, oh, we want to use Wagos. Well, we'll watch out for an unearthed video on that to see if you can actually do that.
Yeah.
And it's obviously got these locking rings as well. So you don't actually need a cable gland with this because obviously the box itself, the gel is providing the IP rating. These are just for, shall we say, strain relief.
They are. And when you talk about IP rating, Gordon, what is the IP rating of the Fred?
So these are dual IP rated, IP68, which is suitable for use in water, fully immersed in water, and 69, which again is hot jets of water. So possibly something in a food environment or somewhere, possibly cleaning down, you know, areas on a regular basis.
So what we do is we've got a shortened version of me making the connections off this, and we'll talk you through those as we go. So the Fred itself needs the splits in top and bottom, which we showed previously when we looked at the Fox box. We've got to split the plastic on both sides. The cable itself comes into the box 25 mil conductor length and 6 mil of insulation removed, and we connect those up. You'll notice we're making the connections, Gordon, not inside the enclosure.
All right, so you're doing all your prep before you even introduce it to the box itself.
Okay. Yeah. Key that we get our gland nuts on as well, so you notice it there on the flex for the actual light fin. I've ferruled my ends.
Yeah. I'd never forget that.
No, take four. And then we connect those up. Okay, so we've got those, and then we introduce our Fred, squeeze it into position. So remember, we're just going to squeeze it together and click it into position, and then we just lock off our nuts, both top and bottom. Now it's a bit of claret there, as I've obviously caught my finger at some point. So we lock those off, and then we're nicely IP rated there. There's our finished product, and then we just put a few more of those fire clips in. Yeah,
that's a neat install. Now just I don't know if you want to bring the camera
here. Yeah, sorry,
but just so I can get a hand scale here. That's a tiny floodlight.
It is a tiny floodlight.
And that's a tiny connection.
Okay, that is a tiny box.
And obviously, yes, you've used the clips.
Yeah.
You've used the clips to obviously secure your cable around. That makes a very, very tidy install.
Yeah.
Sort of almost invisible.
Yeah, we like that, don't we?
Yeah. Perhaps it would be nice to see one fixing on the box itself. But again, those clips we're using there have held it really firmly in place.
They have, yeah. So we've got the IP rating, we've got a very small enclosure. We've got an unearthed now that suggests whether we can or can't get Vargo or Wago connectors, whatever you want, inside the actual fitting box itself. I'm not so keen as you are on that, but you think they can go in. Anything else you want to pick up?
Well, obviously the scenario you could have is where you've got a floodlight and possibly a separate PIR.
Okay, or another floodlight maybe?
Yeah, or you're spurring off to another floodlight. So they do have this Y version or a three-way version of it.
Okay, yeah.
That comes with this Allen head screw terminal blocks there.
Right.
Obviously, the first thing, why I went so keen on the Wagos, Gary, you're going to put a PI on, you're going to need a fourth terminal for that switch live.
Yeah.
So that would drop in there, but obviously, if you needed an extra switching terminal, you'd have to add another terminal. But this has got, it's the same principle, and it just latches shut. And you can open them again.
Yeah, you can. Yeah. Open them up and get back in there, pull out your connections and go again. Yeah. I think they're good.
They're
fit for purpose is what we like here. So I fitted the little thread, the through, if you want to call it though, so in order to make my connections from an NYY cable and an outside light. But we're always interested in your comments. What's your go-to box when making similar connections on the outside of a building, say for floodlights, etc.? Please leave those comments below and we'll get back to as many as we can.